Starting off this edition first with some breaking developments coming in over the Maldivian medal. The question that is now being raised is outgoing Maldivian President Abdullah Yameen planning to stay in power despite being defeated in the elections? That's the big news coming in from India's neighbor. Yameen's party has reiterated that the elections have been tarnished. Remember, Yameen had also approached the country's Supreme Court with a petition questioning the election results and calling for fresh elections. Let's get in further details from Siddhant Sibyl, our principal diplomatic correspondent, who's joining us for more on that. Siddhant, the last few hours have seen multiple developments when it comes to the Maldivian medal. But first up, take us through what happened in the Supreme Court today as Abdullah Yameen refuses to let go of power, had approached the court calling for fresh elections and also in that petition had called the elections as being rigged.
Well, it was a day of dramatic developments in Malé, in Maldives. A lot of developments happening, including in the Supreme Court. And, of course, the Yameen's party had taken the entire thing into the court. It's a courtroom drama. It's a courtroom battle which is taking place in Maldives. And both the sides have presented their cases. And now the Supreme Court did hear both the sides. And now the case has been adjourned. Till tomorrow morning, Maldives time, it will take start the entire case at 10:30 a.m. That's 11 p.m. Indian Standard Time, when the case will again start and both the sides will present more of their views in front of the Supreme Court. But other than that, in last few hours, another dramatic development has taken place. Yameen's party has come out with a strong statement which has rejected the elections which took place last month in Maldives, calling them that they do not match international standards, and the election also says that there were, of course, discrepancies. So clearly it seems that Yameen is making sure that he will not let go of power in the country, and that is why he has taken the entire thing to the court. And interestingly, it was Yameen's party and Yameen-led government that came out with strong statement ahead of the elections and after the election, saying that they do believe in the elections. They do believe in the Election Commission of Maldives and the Lord Election Commission of Maldives, saying that they are doing a transparent job. But now it's a U-turn by the same party, coming out with statements, dragging the entire thing to the court, clearly saying that they do not believe in the Election Commission. So there is a double speak by his party.
Indeed, given that Yameen had conceded defeat soon after the election results, he'd wasted no time and had accepted those results. But let's also take a step back, Siddhant, and take a look at the context in which these developments are taking place. The United States has strongly and categorically said that any attempt by Yameen to cling on to power will invite strong action. The European Union also talking in the same tone. Many within the opposition quarters in the Maldives also, urging Yameen to let go of this battle and allow a peaceful transition of power.
Well, yes, the West is backing the opposition, and the Maldivian opposition is also reaching out to India. Yesterday, Dunia Mamoon, who was a former foreign minister of Maldives and daughter of the famous president, Mr. Abdul Gayoom, who was instrumental in leading democracy in Maldives, visited India and had informal meetings with India's external affairs minister. This is important because this is the first high-level political person coming from Maldives and meeting India's foreign minister. This informal meeting took place at around 6 p.m. yesterday at the residence of India's external affairs minister. And after that meeting, she spoke exclusively to Wion and she used these terms. These are quite undiplomatic terms, but he said that Yameen is a sore loser and he's not letting go of power. This is a strong statement by a person who will be playing an important role in the next government. The next government, the President Ibrahim takes charge from 17th of November. And our sources also tell us that the Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi might be taking part in the oath-taking ceremony of the new president.
All right, we're going to leave it there for the moment, Siddhant. Of course, keep tracking those developments and those reactions that you've been getting us as well. And as Siddhant was pointing out, that exclusive conversation that he had with the former Maldives foreign minister and daughter of the ex-president of Maldives, Mamoon Abdul Gayoom. Dunya Mamoon in India, speaking exclusively to Wion, expressed her hope for rebuilding bilateral ties with New Delhi. Take a listen in now to that conversation.